So my friend here, what's your movie title?
My movie is called Poison Ivy.
Oh!
I'm aware that there is an old movie called Poison Ivy.
Oh, is it
a bit of a thriller?
Is there?
Yeah. So
same character?
No, it's not a Poison Ivy movie. It's not based on the comic book character. It is.
Gotcha.
I think an erotic thriller. So let's forget that exists. Anyway, I'm picturing this as a bit of a revenge thriller slash action movie in the style of John Wick.
Oh.
So here's my story. It draws a bit from the lore of Poison Ivy. By lore, I mean I had a quick look at Wikipedia.
So did I.
No shame.
Anyway, Dr. Pamela Isley is working as a botanist slash chemist at the Gotham Botanical Gardens when some strange things start happening in the neighborhood.
Ooh, what strange things?
Who are you going to call? When something strange starts happening, her colleagues start dying. They start turning green and you see their veins turn black and they pretty much have a little seizure and die.
Good, good.
This is a family-friendly film.
I don't like you locking eyes with me while talking about violent, gruesome deaths.
So her colleagues start dying horrible deaths, and she finds out it's a result of a poisonous spore.
Mm.
And she figures she could be next. She gets to the bottom of this, and she discovers that it was a targeted attack. It was a targeted attack utilizing their botanic research to create bioweapons.
Oh, nice.
And so the botanists are getting killed off. Everyone working on this project is getting killed off to cover up the tracks of these mysterious gangsters. And yeah, everyone gets killed off, including her love interest and colleague, Louisa Cruz.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Nice.
So they burn down the lab and Pamela Isley is dying. She's getting affected by the spores as well, and but hers is a little prolonged, her death is a little prolonged, so she has time to actually make herself a serum, like an antidote,
mm-hmm.
to kind of cure her and, you know, keep her alive, but
like a suppressant.
Yeah. And she starts, as a side effect, she starts turning green and discovers that she has a newfound connection to flora and vegetation.
She-Hulk.
And she can even have some control over them.
Whoa! Mr. Like.
And yeah, she's out for revenge, folks. We'll have some cameos from other familiar Batman characters. We can have Catwoman, we can have Harley Quinn, Riddler, etc. But
all of them.
Yes.
And more.
Holding hands. But at the core of it, this is Poison Ivy's film. And it's about her quest to get revenge and get to the bottom of this. We get some detective work and we have some noir mystery elements to it. She starts investigating different victims of these attacks, and she tracks down gangsters and villains to get to the bottom of this cold case, as it were. She starts getting consumed by anger and goes on a killing spree through different locations and familiar locales in Gotham. Different, very big action set pieces. As she gets closer and closer to finding out the culprits behind the killings. This is a violent movie, man.
But it sounds very dark.
We're gonna get trees and freaking branches impaling gangsters. We're gonna get people sucked into the ground.
Oh, I love it.
As we get further and further into the movie, she starts getting more powerful. She starts gaining every power we know that she has in the comic. She starts getting mind control. She starts having more control over the vegetation.
Mm-hmm.
Here's the big twist that you all have been waiting for. Guess who's behind all these attacks and all these killings?
I can take a guess, but I don't want to spoil it.
It's Jonathan Crane, aka the Scarecrow.
No, that wasn't what I was going to say.
What were you going to say?
A boyfriend.
Oh.
Girlfriend. Whatever.
So Jonathan Crane, aka the Scarecrow, has been the mastermind behind everything. He's using the research to fuel his new fear toxin, and he plans to unleash it on poor, poor Gotham.
And it makes sense, because Poison Ivy is pretty much a lone villain.
Yeah, anyway. Here she is being portrayed as a bit of an anti-hero.
Mm.
Ooh. And she goes off the freaking edge, man. She gets more savage, she gets more cruel. She starts, like, killing fools, man. Killing them.
The cabinet. Ice these fools.
Happens to Murgatroyd. Exit stage left, even.
What?
Yeah, and by the end, the villain, Poison Ivy, is born. And then we show the title, Poison Ivy. That's the movie you've been watching. Yes.
Oh.
That's something new that hasn't been done in recent cinema.
Wait, say that again.
It's fantastic.
Say that again.
It's fantastic.
As Scarecrow's dying, he says, you're poison, Ivy. And she's like, say that again. Say that again.
That's exactly what I was picturing, I promise.
You've poisoned me, Ivy.
She puts her hand over
Yeah.
Wait, say that again.
Say that again. That is pretty much the gist of my movie.
Yeah. Who are you casting? And who is the director of this film?
I'm glad you asked. Because I have David Leitch, or Litch.
We cannot pronounce
it. Yeah, these names. Are just some strange names we got here, folks.
Dr. Strange?
Say that again. David Leitch. Are you familiar with that name?
Vaguely.
Well, he directed John Wick and Atomic Blonde, which fits
that's,
the style.
That's where I'm not from.
Fits
yep.
the style of the movie I'm going for. Mm-hmm. And more recently, he directed Deadpool 2. Yeah, we know from his previous movies that he can direct action and female characters well. We know that he can embrace the darker aspects of these characters while still making it look visually appealing. And really, his action scenes are top-notch, so I think that would be fitting. As for my cast, I picked a lot of popular fan casts for these characters. I have Jessica Chastain as Poison Ivy. I have Marina Baccarin. Damn it! What's up with these names? Marina Baccarin, who has expressed interest in playing Catwoman. She'll have a little bit of a small role in there. We have Margot Robbie, of course, as Harley Quinn. And we have Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn. Jim Carrey, I'm bringing him back as the Riddler.
That's pretty good.
He'll play a bit of a more damaged, darker Riddler. We have Tom Selleck as Carmine Falcone.
So just going back, there's the perfect mustache casting, by the
way. Yeah, exactly. That man is pretty much 90% mustache,
absolutely.
10% human. We also have Michael Emerson as Jonathan Crane. He plays Benjamin Linus in Lost. And he has a bit of a creepy look to him. I'm like, yeah,
perfect.
I feel like he would make a good creepy
that
scarecrow.
Excellent casting, that one.
Yeah, that's my Poison Ivy film. Will you fund me? Will you go fund me?
I have 30 cents. No, I don't. I gave it to charity.
Anyway, those are our pitches for what we hope to be to be full-fledged Hollywood movies.
You listening, Kevin Feige? And whoever the DC guy is?
And you can release them alongside all these other villain movies that's coming out. We have Venom, we have Black Adam, we have Harley Quinn.
Carnage, which we don't, but that was going to be my other one I was going to do.
Hope you guys enjoy, because we really had a good time.
We had a ball.
We had a ball.
Two balls, in fact.
Unlike Hitler. Let's make a Hitler solo film.
Oh, no. Hitler.
No. Hitler, a beginning. Because he's... No.
Hitler, a World War story. Oh, Third Reich character.
Oh, jeez, Louise. Let's play him up. He's a sympathetic character.
No! This is so wrong.
Anyway, that just does it for another episode of the KyberQ Show. I'd like to thank TrashKoala for coming back and joining me. You're free to go.
See ya,
pal.
Yeah.
If you guys enjoy this kind of content, please give a like and subscribe. This has been KyberQ.
This has been TrashKoala.
TrashKoala himself, everyone.
In the flesh.
We'll see you in the next one. Till next time.
Bye-bye.